So hello, very good morning to all of you, and welcome to the today's webinar, Internet of Things. Okay, I hope I'm properly audible to all of you. Please give me the confirmation through the chat box. Okay, great. Thank you. So let's continue to the session, and first we'll recap all about the yesterday lecture, and then after we'll continue. We'll talk about the one of the very famous protocol into the IoT domain, that's MQTT protocol. But let's go with the first recap the some particular basic things about the IoT, okay, and its architecture that we discuss into the last lecture. And after that, we'll continue with the discuss into the detail the one of the famous protocol into the IoT, that's MQTT protocol. And after that, we'll talk about the different cloud platforms, and after that, we'll discuss into the detail the security and analytics part into the IoT domain part. Okay, so as we discussed, the Internet of Things nowadays is one of the very famous and emerging technologies, and it's also known as Industrial Internet of Things, Internet of Everything, Sensor for Everything, the Next Generation of Internet, like different terms that's used to define the IoT. And in the simple language, you can also define it. It's a network between different physical devices. In such way, each physical device will able to share their information or data to other physical device. Okay, So, and that we can be designed, or we can design the IoT enabled devices by using the microcontroller, sensor, actuator, protocol, cloud platforms, wireless networking technologies, and different software and applications. And one of the reasons that is booming the market, and nowadays everyone is talking about IoT, is it doesn't matter what is the physical device. We can implement it anywhere, anytime, and with any kind of the device. It could be any industrial machine, or it could be related to the any kind of the sports. Like nowadays we are also using it into the cricket, table tennis, baseball, and different sports. We are using the IoT, and also into the healthcare sectors, different smart wearable devices, into the smart city, obviously, and logistics sector, healthcare sector, smart city, smart home, different places that we can be use it. So we'll also share with you the some of the video, and that will be different use cases, because nowadays industries, they're also implementing like IoT with the augmented reality, IoT with the big data analytics, IoT with artificial intelligence and different technologies. We can be interface it and build some solutions. Today we'll discuss into the detail one of the very famous protocols into the IoT domain, that is MQTT protocol. And after that, we'll also talk about the some of the different famous cloud services like AWS, Azure, and security paths. Okay. So let me just recap this all about the part. Okay. So as we discuss, IoT is a network between different physical devices, and it's having the unique address, whatever the different devices will be connected to the network. And so that they can be using a different wireless networking technologies, we can build a network between different physical devices. Then using the microcontroller, sensor, accelerators, we can be read the data and perform some actions. And by using the different standards and the protocols, so the devices can be communicate over the network and able to share the data. And IoT is nowadays is not only to create a network, build a network between different physical devices. In order to collect the huge amount of data, we are also using the IoT. Like right now, if you want to collect the data from your agriculture land, because in the agriculture sector is widely nowadays we're using the IoT and artificial intelligence, big data analytics, such kind of the technologies. But obviously like big data analytics or the artificial intelligence to implement it, we require a huge amount of data. And the data we can be collect from using to the IoT technologies, from agriculture land, from the different places that we can be collect. And once we have a data, because the data is something represent to the information about our physical device, then we can be implement such kind of the technologies and design the different kind of solutions over there. Okay. So as we discussed, like here you can see the different companies, industries, they define the IoT, they use the different terms like IIoT, sensor for everything, the next generation for internet. They start with your things according to the Microsoft. It doesn't matter what is your physical device. The boss is the next generation of internet. This kind of the different terms that is used by the different companies. And obviously, like we also discussed the different hardware platforms like Raspberry Pi, Mac, Arduino, Intel board, Fruiter, and Banana Pi. Different microcontrollers are available in the market, or you can see the hardware platforms, and that we can be use it and interface with the different sensor and actuator, wireless networking technologies, and easily program it, and we can be build a IoT enabled devices. So generally the IoT, when we talk about the smart devices, then there is something kind of IoT concept, because IoT gives something, convert our normal device into the smart device. Through that, when we say the smart means the devices which they're able to communicate, will able to take us some decisions over the smart and intelligence. So using the IoT and AI techniques that we can be designing the smart and intelligent devices. So that's why is nowadays in the very famous into the manufacturing industry, especially for in order to achieve the goal of industry 4.0 is play very important roles. Okay. So let me just go back to the MQTT protocol. And first we'll discuss about the architecture of the MQTT protocol. And after that, we'll go into the detail, like we discuss about the different features like retain, quality of service, and different things that, and we'll also implement this particular part through the programming. Okay. So let's go back to the MQTT protocol and let's try to understand their concepts, because that's something very the famous. And even using to the MQTT protocol, we can connect with the any cloud platforms and design the very good IoT solutions like AWS, Microsoft Azure, or IBM platforms, IBM Watsons, and or IBM Bluemix cloud services, the Google IoT platforms, Google IoT solutions, ThingWorx industrial IoT solutions platforms. We can connect to this all over the platform using to the MQTT protocol, because the MQTT is a very standard and it support almost all over the kind of platforms. So we can be connect our physical device using the MQTT protocol and share the data over there. And once we have a data on the clouds, we can do the loss of things, because now you have information about your physical device. Once you have information, you can do the loss of things. You can be use those information, take some good business decision. You can extract the, we can extract the informations. We can be extract some information from the data, and then it will help us to take some good business decisions. We can design some recommendation solution. We can do the forecasting. Okay, we can design some predictive solution. So different things that we can be do, but only if you have a data, and that kind of data we can be create, collect using to the IoT. And that's why it's also known as the one of the very good way of the data streaming. Okay, so all of you, if you have any question, you can also let me know through the chat box. Now we're just going through the particular MQTT protocol. Okay, and we'll discuss into the details. And meanwhile, if you have any question, any doubts or any questions, so you can also let me know through the chat box. We can discuss on that. Okay. So let's go with the MQTT protocol. So MQTT stands for Message Queuing Telemetry Transport Protocol. So there is one question, what is the use of the MQTT protocol? Okay, so you know, like this is the communication protocol. So through that, we can share the data, we can communicate through the internet. Maybe you heard about, like, suppose that to sending the mail, if suppose that to send the mail or to receive the mail, we use the SMTP, okay, or POP3 or IMAP protocol. To sending the file, we use the FTP protocol. Okay, so same thing, like if your web browser by default use the HTTP protocol, and whenever if your laptop is a particular connected to the internet, so if you enter the any particular IP address on your web browser, so by default, it's used the HTTP or HTTPS protocols, and able to using those protocol, it able to your web browser able to communicate with the particular server, like Google server. Like when we enter the Google code.in, so this is the IP address, Facebook.com, LinkedIn.com, TechTrunk.in. So this is the particular IP address. And whenever we enter this IP address on our web browser and your laptop is connected to the internet, so web browser will able to communicate with the particular server. And that server is not on the same place, it's some other place. But using that protocol, our web browser will able to communicate and share the data, transfer the data. So same thing in the using the SMTP or using the POP3 IMAP protocols, we can send the email or receive the email. So for different purpose, we use different communication protocols. Use of that, we can be communicate through the internet. Okay. So if you heard like about the TCP/IP model or OSI model, so in that there's a application layer protocols. Using the application layer protocols, we can be communicate and share the transfer the particular data through the internet, right? So how to use the MQTT protocols? Like suppose if you have a two device, now both two device should be able to transfer the data or able to communicate. So we can be used over there the MQTT protocol. But again, this is a internet-based protocol. So both should be have an internet connectivity. Let me just explain you into the detail, and then we'll go with the MQTT protocol. Okay. Let me just connect to my notepad to here. Then after we'll discuss into the detail and understand this particular part. So don't keep any doubt. If you have any question, you can let me know. Okay, we can definitely discuss on that part. Okay, let's suppose that there is one question, then how to use the MQTT protocol. So let's suppose that you have one physical device. Okay, you have second physical device, like any robot. Or suppose that this is your mobile phone. Now what you want to get a data from the, or you want to control this machine through your mobile phone, or you want to get a data from this particular robot. Like in this robot, you just interface different sensor here, like what is the torque on this point, what is the particular force on this particular point, what is the stress on this particular point. Okay, so you want to collect some data, because use of this data, this is the something factor which is the highly responsible for such kind of failure in this machine. Now you want to design some solutions so that you can do the, you can predict their maintenance or their failure. You want to predict their failure. So the first, you should have a data of the particular factor which is highly responsible for such kind of the failure. So you can attach the different sensor over there, different microcontrollers, and use of that we can read the data. After that, we can also interface the Wi-Fi module so that we can be connected to the some internet. So like suppose that this is the connected to the some Wi-Fi module and connected to the internet, right? Same thing in your mobile phone, there is also internet connection, right? Both are connected to the internet, so we can be use the internet based communication protocol like MQTT. Like we also use the HTTP, same thing like MQTT protocol, message queuing telemetry transfer protocol. And now we can program the MQTT protocol into the both microcontroller, both places. Like here we can be use some simulation software in our mobile phone, or here, or suppose that this is your laptop. Okay, so we can be program some using some programming language, we can be program and run the program. So we can will able to receive the data from the particular our machines, or we can send some data to the machine so that we can will able to control our machine. Okay, let's see this particular part, and then if you have any question, you can let me know. Okay, so let's first, because now we are doing, we want to transfer this particular data, we can also do using the HTTP protocol, but MQTT is something very famous. So let's go with the MQTT protocol. But in order to implement the MQTT protocol, first we should have understanding about the architecture. Okay, so let's talk about the architecture of MQTT protocol, and after that we'll implement this particular part through the some coding. We are not going to use some simulator, we'll use some coding, and through the coding part we'll try to implement this particular part, and even I'll be explain each and every end of all of the particular code. Okay, so don't worry about that. Okay, so let's, I hope you all of you are clear with this particular part, why how we can be use the MQTT protocol. So let's go and discuss about the architecture of MQTT protocol, message queuing telemetry transfer protocol. I hope it's clear for all of you. Can you please give me the confirmation so that we can go with the architecture of MQTT protocol? Or if you have any question, you can also let me know. Okay, great. Okay, so here you can see this is the architecture of the MQTT protocol, and as we know, like all of you, I hope you already have you know that like HTTP protocol, the architecture is request and response basis. So there's a one question, why we are using the MQTT protocol if you have already the HTTP protocol. So you can see HTTP protocol, there should be one client and server, and if the server having the data, then only you'll able, client will able to receive those kind of the data, or will able to find those data. Like suppose the sometimes what happened, if you search something on the Google, suppose if that data Google don't have such kind of the data, if the Google don't have such kind of the data, so you won't able to receive that kind of reply or something, answer from the particular Google server or some any particular website. Means if the server having the information, then first client make a request to the server, I want this information, and server send the information in the form of the response. But for that, server should have a kind of data. So this is not live streaming. Okay, this is not a messaging protocol. We can save some kind of the database on the server part. We can put it some database, some kind of the information on the server, and whenever the client require that information, client can send the request over the server and server send the response. So this is not live messaging protocol. Okay, live streaming or the messaging protocol, but MQTT is a messaging protocol. So even at the same time, we can transfer the particular data. There will be very, very small fraction of seconds kind of the delay. Okay, so both are different, is the for machine to the machine communication, for live streaming that we can be use it. So yeah, didn't get your money, come again. Yeah, we can be, this is the messaging protocol. So like what happened, like your Facebook Messenger, whenever you send the message, at the same time the receiver can be receive the particular message. It's a messaging protocol, but HTTP is not a messaging protocol. Here, if the server have information, then server can send the particular client. But here, at the same time, we are sending, and the receiver is also within some delay, or maybe the within some fraction of seconds, or maybe the 1 or 2 seconds, a receiver part can be receive the particular data. Yeah, exactly. The messaging protocol. You can see. So let's talk about the architecture of it. So here, as we discuss. So in the MQTT, there are main two parts. One is MQTT client and MQTT broker. So what is the broker? Right now you can just consider this is the such kind of the software. Okay, that we can be installed in the particular server or in our laptop, and it will be work as a broker. And what is the use of the broker? Broker is used for to exchange the messages, okay, or to route the particular message, to exchange the particular message. Because in the HTTP, what happened, the client can directly send a request to the server, and server can directly will send the particular, means client and server both can directly communicate. Means your web browser work as a client, and server means Google server, maybe the some other places. So client can directly send a request to the server, because client having the IP address of the server, it can directly send the request to the server, and server send her particular response and with the particular answer, okay, with the some information. But here in the MQTT protocol, like supposed if they are the multiple client. So what is the client, like suppose that if I want to share some messages to you, so both known as the client, like suppose that here in previous case the mobile phone, and this in the mobile phone and the particular robot or machine, both are the clients, both and users are the client. Suppose that if we have three different users, like laptop, mobile phone and the robot or some machine, so all threes are clients. Okay, but into the MQTT protocol, all over the clients cannot directly communicate with each other. All over the clients cannot directly communicate with each other, can only communicate through the some middle party or the broker. The some middle party and the broker. This is the architecture of the MQTT protocol. So, and why we are talking about the architecture, because we want to implement it. So you should have an idea about that. So for this should be the client and the broker, then only we'll able to write a program for it. If you don't know, so you won't be able to write the program for this particular part. You won't be able to understand it. Okay, so there is some broker. So you can just suppose that we can be use some broker, and we can install some broker on the server or in our laptop. That software, we can install it in our laptop, and our laptop will be work as a broker. And the software are something, because these are open source software or open source broker are Mosquito, Mosca, HiveMQ. So this is the HiveMQ is one of the broker that we can be installed in our server or in the laptop, and it will work as a broker. Or otherwise, there's also some broker like Mosquito, Mosca, HiveMQ, and many more. So, but these are some famous and open source broker so that we can be installed it. Okay. And the clients are end user. Okay. And what is the use of broker? To route the messages between or to send, transfer the messages between the different clients. Between the different clients. But again, the one of the big question is, suppose that I am sending some message to the broker and you are also sending some message to the broker, but how the particular broker will be differentiate between the both messages, how the broker will be come to know about that this message transferred to this client or this other client. So broker, so generally here what happened, it's use the topic name, the unique feature are the topic name. That's something user defined. That is something user defined. So what happened, like if suppose that any client want to send their data, so first it will be published their data to the broker with the topic name. If suppose that I want to send some data to you, so first I'll be send my data to the broker with the topic name. So this, if the client is sending the data to the broker with the topic name, so this client known as a publisher, is known as publisher. Or suppose there's some other client like laptop and mobile phone know the particular that topic name used by corresponding client to send the data. So if it's known the is this laptop and mobile device know that particular topic name, then first it have to subscribe to the broker using the same topic name. Using the same topic name, it have to subscribe to the broker, and then the broker will be filtered that message based on the topic name, and it will be resent to the it will be sent to the particular subscriber. Okay, let me just explain you again. Suppose that there's a A and there's a B. Okay, A is sending the message using the topic name 12. Okay. And B is sending the message using the topic name 34. Okay. And here the message is hello. And here the message is IoT. Okay. Means A is sending the message to the broker using the topic name 12 and message is hello. And B is sending the IoT message to the broker using the topic name 34. Suppose that if so what happened, if the laptop is subscribing using the topic name 12, so broker will be filter the message with the word 12. What is the message? The message is hello. So it will be send the hello message to here. If the mobile device will be subscribed using the 34 topic name to the broker, then the broker will be filter what is the message with the 34 topic name. So this is something IoT. So it will be sent to the mobile device. I hope it's clear. Please let me know, all of you. And one more thing, all of the protocols generally use some particular topic names. Okay, some topic names. Like for HTTP protocol, you may be heard, like whenever you open the any website, HTTP protocol by default use a port number 80. And HTTPS protocol use the port number 443. Same thing, MQTT protocol, without any SSL, without any security, it used 183, and MQTT with the transport layer security, it's used the port number 883. Okay, if the mobile, there's one question, if the mobile device subscribe to the topic 34, it receive the message IoT. Yes, yes. If the mobile device, so it depends on the topic name. If suppose the laptop will be subscribed using the 34, so it will be again, it will be also receive the IoT message. Because the broker is generally filter the message based on the topic name. If any subscriber, if suppose that at the same time, if they're the 5 subscriber and all of the 5 subscriber are using the same topic name to, all of the clients are using the same topic name and subscribing to the broker, so all subscriber will receive the same messages. At the same time, there may be the mini subscriber, at the same time, there may be the many subscribers. Remember yesterday we also implemented, I was trying to publish some messages on the same one topic name, and all of you are using your laptop or using the particular some software, you are trying to subscribe the same topic name, and all of you are able to receive the message. So at the same time, there may be the many subscriber. Okay, so this is one question. Please explain to the 183 and 3883. Okay, like all over the protocols, like all over the application layer protocols like HTTP, MQTT, SMTP, IMAP, POP3, FTP protocols, use some port number, fixed port number. Okay, in order to communicate, it's use the fixed port number. Like HTTP protocols, like what happened? If you enter the any website, like TechTrunk.in. So by default, it's if it's the using the HTTP protocol, so it will be start with the colon 80. So 80 is the port number. If the this website is this server using the particular security SSL transporter security, if so, it will be used the HTTPS. So it will be start with TechTrunk. Dot in colon 443. So this is the port number, is something fixed, is the fix for the particular port number, particular protocols. So HTTP use the port number 80 without any SSL transport layer security. With the transport layer security is use the 443. Same thing MQTT without any security. You remember yesterday we by default the port number was 183 because we did not use any security features like public key, private key, for encryption, data encryptions, for digital certificates, such kind of things. Okay, so with the SSL and data security, it's use the 3.83 port number. So whenever you will be connect to the some standard platform like AWS IoT, Azure IoT, IBM IoT platforms, so we require or some certificate for authentication purpose. You know, enabled in order to enable the security, we'll use some certificate like public key, private key, digital certificate. Okay, so for the authentication and data security, so in that case we'll use the 3.83 port number. Yes, so 443 is used for HTTP, for the HTTP is secure one. Same thing for MQTT, we use 3.83 and 183. So there is a question, sir, it is possible to single subscriber user to many topic name. Yeah, it's possible. Single subscriber can be used to or many topic name. It is also possible. That's possible, Moshe. A subscriber can be subscribed at same time many topic name. Even I'll be show you some example. Don't worry about that. Okay, I will do this some practical also. Okay. I hope is it clear, right? So please let me know. Then again, we'll move on the practical part and we'll discuss about the particular packages like the Power MQTT. So how to configure the broker? Yeah, that's something good question. So what happened, like as we discussed. Okay, sure, that I'll give that. Okay, let me just come to the one by one, the all about the question. So what happened? The first question is how to configure the broker. So as we discuss broker part, so there is some cloud-based broker, public cloud-based broker like iot.eclipse.org. But yesterday we also used broker.hivemq.com. So there are some very open public broker are available that we can be use it without any SSL security. Even we can also use the AWS, Azure, and IBM services. Or even this is the cloud-based broker. So you can just mention the IP address of it, and you can, so what will be the structure of the programming? So the first will be create a client. We'll create a client. Then after we connect to the client to the broker. So right now this client may be the publisher and subscriber. First step is to create a client. Second step is to connect to the client to the broker. And third step, it may be we can write a program for the publisher or subscriber part, because client could be the publisher, client could be the subscriber. Okay, So all means both publisher and subscriber are the client. But if the client is publishing the data, that client known as a publisher. If the client is subscribing to the topic, that client known as a subscriber. Okay. So suppose that if your client to connect the broker, if it is using some transport layer security, so we use a 8883 protocol like SSL security. If the client is not using the any security features to connect with the broker, so we'll use the 183 port number. Okay, if the client using the some SSL transport layer security to connect the broker, if it is not using, so we'll use the 183. If it is using some security features to connect with the broker, we'll use the 8883 port number. Okay, so this port number, like how to configure the broker, either you can be just install some software in your laptop, and at the place of iot.eclipse.org you can mention the IP address of your laptop. But in again, we can only implement this particular part into the local network. But if you want to implement, if you want to transfer the data from anywhere to any places, so we can use the cloud-based broker. And these are the some cloud-based broker. So we need to mention the IP address of this broker in our program. Like remember yesterday we used the broker.hivemq.com. So this is the IP address of this cloud. Okay, so either if you're installing such software into your laptop, so you can mention the IP address of your laptop. Okay, so but again, if you're, so it will be local, into the local network you'll able to implement it. But into the cloud based broker, so you can be receive the data, you can be send the data, transfer the data from anywhere. It depend on the coverage of that particular cloud. Okay. If you use the broker without the security, the data is not safe. Yeah. If they use the particular broker, if you are not using any security feature, then again, it's not secure. Remember, like if your website is start with the HTTPS, then you should not do any kind of the payment on with that particular website. If you are doing directly payment on that websites, so you should be not do any kind of the payments over there. So it should be the very secure. The website should be the very, if the generally you can see that most of the website like Flipkart, Amazon's, it's generally used HTTPS, but normal website is generally don't use the, is generally used HTTP. So here we don't require, if you just want to share some information, but if you're trying to share the some critical information, very informative and the private information like your credit card detail, your account details, so that make sure that that website start with the HTTPS. Is user as self transport layer security. Okay, there's another question like without a specifying topic name, how can, okay. If you use AWS cloud means there is some time period only. No. We are just, because AWS cloud service is already available, we can be connected and all of the processing will be through the cloud only. Because if you, because we cannot directly communicate, we'll send the message here, and then after it will be send the message to the particular part. So there will be always broker in the picture. It may be in the cloud or it may be in the particular. So we, if you're using a cloud-based broker, so you don't need to do any things. There are already cloud services are broker on that services are available. You need to connect on that particular part by using the IP address. To verify that, I'll show you some example. Yes, right. So let me check the other multiple questions. So this is one question from Lakshmi that for HTTPS we use like HTTPS. Yes. Okay. For same thing. MQTT, yes. Like in your web browser generally does not support to MQTT protocol. Your web browser support to the only the HTTP protocol. Remember, for sending the mail, we are using the SMTP protocol, but we are generally not able to see sometimes on this thing on the our web browser because our web browser only support HTTP protocol. But apart from the web browser, there are lots of things to connect and to share the data. Like we are doing the email through the email also, we are sending the data, right? But over there, we are using the SMTP protocol. But our web browser use only the HTTP and WebSocket. You can see some website also start with the WebSocket WS. So your web browser mostly support to the WebSocket and HTTP protocol. That's why you are, because we are very much familiar. We are into the daily, we use the particular web browsers to connect with the different servers and all. So, but apart from HTTP, there are lots of the protocol, but web browser only support to WebSocket and HTTP only. Okay. We can configure the MQTT protocols like SMTP, like FTP and different way. So these are one questions like is AWS is yeah, you can no in AWS the loss of web services. AWS is loss of the web services. One of the services IoT service. So in that we can be used a cloud-based broker of the IoT services, not all of the services. Okay. AWS provide the loss of web services, lots of the services like Elasticsearch, notifications, artificial intelligence, machine learning, IoT. So their IoT services we can be used, and they are one of the services IoT core. So we can use it as a cloud-based broker. Okay. That gateway we can be use it to connect it over there. Yeah, AWS provide 1 year free services. So we can use 1 year, even I'll be show you today also how to connect with the AWS, don't worry about that. 1 year free services AWS provide. So we can be, most of the service AWS provide 1 year, 12 months or some particular ask basis. So we can be used most of the 1 year free trial services. We can be used AWS service, AWS provide 1 year free trial services that we can use it. Like Azure provide mostly service 1 month and 12 months of the particular free services. Okay, so let's go with this. If you have any other question, you can also let me know. Otherwise, we'll continue with the MQTT protocol and discuss into the detail. Okay, I hope it's fine for all of you. Great. If you have any question, then please let me know. Okay, great. So now let's see. I'll come again on the AWS is useful. So AWS means Amazon Web Services. AWS is clouds, like you can see, Microsoft Azure, AWS, Amazon's web services, IBM, Google provide lots of web services. Web services means you can see lots of the solutions, cloud solution you can say. And one of the service is IoT service that we can be use it to connect our physical device to the AWS IoT platforms and transfer. Like yesterday we used a broker.hivemq.com. So it is a something a public services, so public platform is not secure. We cannot use for industrial purpose. For normal learning purpose, we can be use the broker.hivemq.com, it.eclipse.org, but for industrial application, for any production side, we cannot use the such platform. So for that, we can be use AWS IoT services, Microsoft Azure IoT services, or IBM IoT services, or some standard platform we can be use it. So one of the services AWS provides lots of services. One of the services is IoT service, and that we are talking about that. Okay. So let me just go come back to bit here, and then we'll discuss into the detail. So you can see there's a lots of the different kind of the Mosquito, Mosca, HiveMQ, the broker that we can be installed in our laptop, and we can be mention the particular IP address and connect implement over there. But it will work into the local network, right? So let me just come back to here. And okay, so the first thing to for the implementation part, I will use the particular Python as a programming language, and one of the package of the Python that is a PaHoMQTT. PaHoMQTT is a very famous library that is designed by the Eclipse Foundation, and we can be use it in order to implement the particular MQTT protocol. And one more things like this package, we can be use it and connect with the all of the standard platforms like AWS IoT services. We can be connected and Microsoft Azure IoT services. Again, I'm telling you the AWS Azure IBM provide the loss of services. We are just talking about the IoT service. Okay. IBM, Google, IoT service. And ThingWorx IoT service. we are just only talking about the IoT services of this particular platform. They provide the lots of different services, IT services. So we are just talking about the IoT service, and that we can be connected using to the MQTT protocol. Okay. So let's go with this particular part. So as we discussed that we'll use the Power MQTT package, and we can be implement over there. So again, the first thing is how to, because first before to write the code, we should have a clear picture about the all of the steps. Okay, so as we know, we already know that particular architecture of it. Okay, so what if we do that? So there are the two things. One is publisher means sender, and subscriber means receiver part. Okay, so what will we do that? We know that publisher is also client. So the, what is the first step is create a client, right? And connect to the client to the broker. Then define the topic name and send the message. Define the message, define the particular topic name and the message and publish it. Right? This is the first step. First, define a client, create a client, connect to the client to the broker. Define the topic names and the message, and yeah, we can also, there's one question here, cryptography is used. So yeah, we can use the cryptography for data encryptions, like we are sending the data through the network. So for data security purpose, we can use a cryptography to encrypt our data, so the persons won't be able to understand our actual message. I'll show you some example, don't worry. Okay, so these are some steps for the publisher part. For subscriber, so again, there's one question, what is a cryptography? So cryptography is a mathematical functions, and that is useful to encrypt your data. Like suppose that what happened, this is my mobile phone and this is the laptop. So this is the particular, okay, this is the particular laptop. Okay, I'm sending the message through the internet. Okay, sending the message like hello. So if there is a third person also connected to the same network, the person will able to understand or read your message. So we do not want to do this particular part 5 because this message is very private for us, and we do not want to allow some third person to read our message or to access our message or to change our message. Okay, like kind of we do the hackings and all such kind of the terms that we use. So here we can be use or cryptography techniques, and before to send our message, we'll encrypt it. So hello will be become such kind of thing. So third person won't be able to understand the actual message because we encrypt it into the some particular format. Now if this person is having some key, so using that key, the persons will be decrypt and convert into the original message. So surely for the data encryption purpose and for the security purpose, we can be use our cryptography techniques. I'll let you know. First, let's discuss this particular part. We'll discuss into the cryptography into the detail, okay, later on, because this is a very, very big topic. So first, let's continue this particular part. Then after, we'll come back on that particular point, okay? So, okay, for subscriber, same thing, we'll do that. We'll create a client. We connect to the client to the broker. Okay, we define, here there's a one more step. We'll define the callback function, and we subscribe to the topic, then we'll define the callback function. That's all, and we'll run the callback function. Okay, so here are some step, like first we'll create a client, we'll connect to the broker, we'll subscribe to the topic, we'll define the callback function, and then we'll run the callback function. So what is the callback function? Because here, you know, what do you create a client? We can create a client, we can connect to the broker, we can subscribe to the topic, but what do you mean by to the callback? So we'll discuss into the detail part. Okay, first let me just go with the publisher program, then after I'll be write a subscriber program, and then we can be easily do this particular part. Okay, I hope is it clear for all of you. I'll be explaining you this all of the code, each and every line, so don't worry about that, okay? So is it fine for all of you? Can you please give me the confirmation? Can we go with that programming part? Yeah, define the callback function. Don't worry about that, okay? Okay, let's go with that. So as I'm just using the Python for it. Okay, so in the Python to call any particular library, we use import keyword. Like in the C program, we use hash include. So same thing here, we generally in the Python, we use import keyword to call some library in our program. So as we discussed, I'll use the Paho MQTT package, Paho MQTT.client. So again, the Paho.MQTT.client is a very big name. So I just going to replace with some alphabet like A. So whenever I'll be mentioned like A, it's my package. That is Paho.MQTT.client. So as we discussed that, first what we'll do, we'll create a client, okay? Yes, I'm using the Python language, yeah. So as what we are doing, first, as we discuss, we'll define, first step is to define the client. So we can define the client in this way. C equals to, C is some variable equals to, A is our package, right? Now A is our library or the package. So A dot client. So we easily define some client here. Okay, we can define, we can create a some client. Now second step is to connect to the client to the broker. So C is now, we create some C variable, C equals to A dot client. A is our package, we create a client, and that's all of the client is inside of C variable. Now we connect to the C, means we are connecting to the broker client. Now here C dot connect, we can define the broker, IP address of the broker. So right now I'm just using the broker, some public broker, cloud-based, hivemq.com. And then we can define the port number. As we discussed, we are not going to use, we are not using any security features. So I'll be use the port number 183, right? So after that, what I'll be do that, while true, I'm just going to put the infinity loops. So this is the infinity loops in the Python. While true means it is always true, okay? So what I want to do that, now we can define our topic name and the message, and we can publish the message. So to publish the message, C dot, because C is the client, you can see we connect, we can define the client, and that's into the C variable, and then we connect to the client to the broker. So we define the IP address of the broker is broker.hivemq.com, and 183 is the port number. After that, we can just publish it. So what is the A? You can see A is the library, you can see. Paho.mqtt.client as A means either A, at the place of A, you can also write the Paho.mqtt.client, but that's something very big name. So I do not want to use again and again. So I just replace with A. You can also mention like B. So here you just need to change as a B. Okay. Now here we can define the topic name. So topic name, suppose that I'm using the ABCD1. After that, we can define the message. So like message. Okay. So you can see this is our topic name and this is the particular message. Right now we can just run this program, and after that we can also give this some delay. So time dot sleep, so after the 2 or 1 second it will be sent again and again. So we can just import, so it's not necessary, we can queue, it's depend on you. Okay, so now you can see we can run this particular program, and let me just show you. Otherwise, now you can be use your mobile application in order if you want to receive the data. And after that, I'll write a code for subscriber. And if you'll publish the data, then I'm able to see the all of the data. Okay. So now you can be use your mobile application if you want to receive the particular data. You can use the mobile applications, that is the MQTT client. You can download this app Android application in your mobile phone and you'll able to receive the messages, because this is some simulation software. Oh, so you can be used this particular part. Otherwise, if you are, have a laptop, so you can be used a MQTT box also, or MQTT client, that Android application that you can be just install it. You'll able to receive the message, send some data, because after that I'll write a subscriber program. So if you'll send some, now you can send some data from your mobile phone, and here on the screen we'll able to visualize this all of the data. Okay, hope is it clear for all of you. So please let me know if you are using this particular application, so that I'll run this program, then you can check it whether you'll able to receive the message or not. Please do that and give me the confirmations. Please let me know, all of you. Okay, if you are using, so let me just put this particular steps. So you can just open the MQTT client app, and after that on the right bottom you will get a plus sign. On the right bottom, so you will get a some plus sign. Just click on the plus sign, and after that some second slide will be appear in front of in your mobile phone. So in that second second option is nickname, so you can just click over there and give the in write any particular name, then after press okay. Okay, after that you can just move down over there and you'll get some another options like a host, right? So you can mention that, because your client should be must be also connected to the same broker. So here my laptop is using the broker.hivemq, so just mention that broker.hivemq.com. okay, and then after that you can just you can move down again and you can define the client ID, like client ID, any unique things that you can be define it, like something like unique. Okay, after that you can move up. There's your options like enable, and for enable you can just move the slider, and after that on the particular add broker in the menu, this is right side of the add broker. On the menu, the right side of the ad broker, a small logo, click on that, so you can save the on information. And after that some second window will be previous window, last window will be appear in front of you, and there will be the some small box. And over there, just click on that. You will get an option subscribe to the topic. And then you can subscribe to the particular topic. So let me know, all of you, if you're able to follow this particular part, so that we'll move, run this particular program. Okay. Please give me the confirmation, all of you, through the chat box if you're able to implement this particular part. So okay, great, if it's done. What about others? Oh great, so let me just run this particular program, and then even you can also say send us some audio, video, and different kind of the messages. So audio, video, text files that we can be transfer, but again this is the messaging protocol. Okay, so now you can check it. Let me know whether we'll able to receive the message or not. Into the subscribe to the topic, just mention ABCD1 and then after click on the subscribe. Okay, here you can just mention ABCD1 because I'm using the topic ABCD1 and click on subscribe. And let me know whether you'll be able to receive the message or not. Please do that and then after give them the confirmation. And after that, I'll write a program for the subscriber. Yeah, great. What about others? Please give me confirmations. Yeah, it doesn't seem like yesterday, but again, yeah, is it right? Perfect. Okay, great. Now I'll write a particular subscriber program and then after, now you can send the message and here we can monitor all of the data. Okay. Now I hope all of you I hope it's fine for all of you, right? So now let me know if you have any question. Otherwise we'll continue with the particular subscriber program and then you can send us some messages. Then here we can be monitored all over the data, right? Oh great, great. So here we are playing which role? You are playing the particular subscriber. Yeah, you are playing as a particular subscriber because you are subscribing to the topic. And my program is working as a, this is the Python 3.6, so yeah. But you can be use the Python 2 and the Python 3, any versions that we can be use it and right. And two, you also need to install this particular package. So make sure that your path is selected. If you're installing the particular Python, your path is selected. Then after you can just open the CMD. And if you want to install the any package, you can just use the pip space install space paho dot mqtt. You can just enter this command and you can see you're able to install this particular packages. Again, you can see here. It's already installed in my case. So if you want to install this package paho.mqtt, so you can just make sure that first install the Python and make sure that particular path is selected. And after that, you can just enter the command pip space install space paho.mqtt. So you can be install this package. And then after you can also write a code and implement this particular part. Okay, I hope it's clear. So now let me just go with the subscriber program. And let's see this particular part. So I think now all of you are okay with this particular. Okay, this is one questions from we did the same things yesterday. So then why I need to create a same thing again? It means the nickname host name is the same, but I try to today's topic name in the yesterday the session is out, but there's, you know, yeah, because what happened by default, that is something session is out. So what happened, you again need to enable you, if you click on the same small boxes, if you click over there for the some time, for the maybe the 1 or 2 second, their setting options will be open, and then after you can just disable it and then again enable it and save the information, then you can use the same part because this is not very standard application. Right. Yeah, definitely. I'll be explaining the callback function again. Then after I'll be go to the subscriber program. Okay. Ashish, like in your case, what happened? Like, this is not a very standard applications. This is normal application we just use for the testing purpose. But if you use very standard industrial app, standard applications, so in that case, you don't need to do this particular part. We don't follow such kind of the issue. Okay. So now you can see here. Let me just go back to the subscriber program and. So here you can see. So in the publisher programs, we have done this all with steps, like we created a client, then after we connected to the broker, we defined topic name and the message, and then after we're able to publish the particular message, and all of you will able to receive the message. So now let's come back to this particular part. So what happened, like client, we can also create a client, we can also connect to the broker in the same way, we can subscribe to the topic, but what about the callback function? So let's understand this this particular pattern, and then only we'll able to understand this particular program. So let me explain you the callback function and then we'll discuss into the detail. Okay, we'll write more on the particular programming part. Yeah, I'm just explaining this particular part. Just give me the 1 second. I'm explaining the callback function and then only we'll go to the programming part. Okay. So what happened here? You can see there's a mobile. Now, suppose that this is your case. My laptop is publishing data to the broker, which is on some cloud. Okay. And once you with some topic name, okay, and whenever you are subscribing using your mobile phone using the same topic name, you'll able to receive the message from the broker, right? This is your case. So your mobile device work as a subscriber, but we are just sending, my laptop is just sending data to the cloud with some topic name, so it work as a publisher. This client known as a publisher, and this mobile device, this particular client known as a subscriber. So what happened, you can see here, but right now you are just using the simulator and some software in order to some Android application in order to receive the particular message. But in the backend side, there's obviously some code and some functions will be there, so that's why you will able to receive the message. So now we are just going to write this code, the backend part, through the programming language from the very scratch. But to do that, we should have a clear picture about the callback function. So what happened? You know, like all over the protocols, either that is based on the TCP or the UDP. The TCP and UDP transport layer, the protocols. The TCP is something very, means you're all over the protocols like HTTP, MQTT, AMQP, or SMTP. So different protocols, all of these protocols, either it's based on the TCP or UDP. So what is the TCP and UDP? So TCP and UDP are the transport layer protocol. Whenever the data is moved through the network, it generally divided into the small chunks, and then after it's there is also it attached to the different IP address of the destination. So this is the transport layer protocol, like TCP and UDP. So some of the protocol is the based on the TCP, some of the protocol is the based on UDP. So TCP is more reliable and UDP is not that much reliable. If your protocol is based on TCP, so it's give the security that your data will be reached on the destination. But UDP based protocol is something is fire and forget. It may be you lose some data, or maybe your data won't be reached on the destination. Let me give you some example. Like if you send some messages through your Facebook Messenger or Skype or the particular your WhatsApp. So whatever the protocol it use, because obviously without internet you won't be able to send the WhatsApp message. Without internet you won't be able to send the email. Without the internet you won't be able to send the particular Facebook message, right? So what happened? This means that it's all over the internet. We are using some protocols over there to send some messages on the either on the Facebook, Skype, or the WhatsApp to transfer some particular messages or to send the messages. We are using some protocols. So this all of the protocol based on the TCP. That's why it's very reliable. If you send some data, so obviously on the destination part or the particular user will be. Corresponding person will be receive that particular messages. But what happened, the some protocol is also run over the UDP, so it's not reliable. Means if you send that, it not give the guarantee that your data packet will be reached on the destination. Let me give the example, like video call or the voice call. I am explaining the callback function, but for that you should have idea about this particular part. Okay, so what happened, like for that, to understand the callback function, first understand the TCP and UDP, then only you will able to understand this particular part. Okay, so what happened here, like some of the protocol like video call, voice call, sometimes whenever you're talking and whenever you're doing the video calling or the voice calling, maybe you sometimes lose some data packets over there. It means that over there, like that particular protocols run over the UDP, so it's something kind of the fire and forget. Okay, so same thing here. Like the MQTT, HTTP, this all about the protocol based on TCP bus protocol. The TCP is something very reliable and it's acknowledgement base. If you perform any action, you generally get an acknowledgement. So this is the main reason, like acknowledgement. Okay, so your MQTT protocol is based on TCP. It's run over the TCP, or TCP based protocol, or acknowledgement. Acknowledgement means if you perform TCP based protocol or acknowledgement means if you perform any action to the client or the server, then you'll get some response from it, and through the acknowledgement you can check the status of that particular action. It means that what happened actually. So this is the for normal, like what happened, suppose that there's one client. Okay, so whenever we are connecting to the broker, whenever client will be tried to connect to the broker, because if you are using the MQTT protocol, so MQTT protocol run over the TCP. Okay, so the broker will be sent some confirmation, and that confirmation known as an acknowledgement, and through the acknowledgement we can check it whether the client is successfully connected to the broker or not. Yeah, generally UDP don't give the on any acknowledgement. TCP is based on acknowledgement. Monisha, I'll be come back. Just wait a minute. Just first try to understand this particular part. Then after I'll come back on your particular points. Okay. Yeah, exactly. The TCP is the based on acknowledgement. Generally, UDP don't based on the particular acknowledgement. And through the acknowledgement, we can check the status of that particular action. This point I'm trying to say you. Okay, so here what happened, like whenever the client will be, because the MQTT protocol, yeah, this is the how we can receive the acknowledgement. Just wait for some time, because this is the main part of a callback function. Okay, and through that we can be receive the particular data. Just wait. So what happened, like here you can see, now in order to receive the acknowledgement we can just run the callback function. Okay, and through the acknowledgement we can check the status of that particular action. So what happened, like here you can see, whenever the client will be connected to the broker, obviously like broker will be sent some acknowledgement, and to receive the acknowledgement we can run the callback function, so we can receive the data from the broker side. Whenever the subscriber, whenever the this mobile device will be subscribed to the topic on the broker, then obviously like broker will be sent some information. Now in order to receive that information, like if you want to receive any information from the broker side, you can run that kind of the callback function. If you want to receive any information from the broker side, so you can run the callback function. So what about the different callback functions are available that we can be use it? So as we discussed, suppose that if you are trying to connect, if your client is trying to connect to the broker, then obviously like broker will be sent some acknowledgement or some information. So in order to run that, in order to, now if you're trying to connect, if the client is trying to connect to the broker, so obviously there will be some kind of acknowledgement. To receive it, we can just run the callback function on underscore connect. Okay, whenever, suppose that if any client is trying to subscribe to the topic, because obviously client will be subscribed to the topic to the broker, then the broker will be sent some confirmation, and through that we can check it whether like client is successfully subscribed or not. So to receive this part, we can receive, we can be run the callback function on underscore subscribe. Because whenever any client will be perform any action to the broker, which kind of action? Connect, publish, subscribe, disconnect. So these are the some action client can perform. Client can be tried to connect to the broker. Client maybe try to disconnect from the broker. Client is trying to subscribe to the topic to the broker. Client is maybe try to unsubscribe to the topic to the broker. Client maybe try to publish some message to the publish some topic to the particular broker. So these are some action that client is performing to the broker. So obviously like broker will be sent some information. In order to receive those information, we can run the callback function. So if you want to receive the information from the connect, so we can run the on underscore connect callback function. If you want to receive the information of the subscribe, so you can run the on underscore subscribe callback function. If you want to receive the information of unsubscribe action, so you can just run the on underscore subscribe callback function. If you, whenever the client is subscribed to the topic, so if you want to receive the message, so you can run the on underscore message callback function. So don't worry about that. I'm just going to write a code. It will be clear. Okay, don't worry about that. Let me just go with the one practicals. I know it's very heavy, so don't worry about that. So okay, let me just go back to the program and explain you this particular part into the detail. Okay, so you can see I'm just going to write a code over there. Okay, so I'll just put it this particular part and cut it this particular part here. Okay, so you can see the same steps, like first we create a client, connect to the client to the broker, and after that we can just define callback function. So I'm just going to define the callback function like okay, I'll do it later. First what I'll be do that here, connect to the broker and c dot let me just give me the 2 seconds. I'll be explaining this particular part again. So what I'm doing here, I'm just, there's a two callback function. You can see I'm trying to define on underscore connect and on underscore message. On underscore connect is check it whether like my client is successfully connected or not, and on underscore message to receive the message whenever my client will be subscribed to the topic, to receive the message from the broker side. I'm using this on underscore message callback function, and that is equals to ABC or ABC1. So what is the ABC and ABC1? I'm going to define the function here in the particular Python. We generally define the function using the def. Okay, see user data flag RC. I'll be explaining this particular part. Just wait 1 second. On underscore message is to receive the message, to receive the message from the broker side. We are just using this callback function. Okay, so you can see I defined my, this is the inbuilt function. You can see this is the part of CC, is the part of our client. So you can see, so whenever I'll be do perform on, whenever I'll be called on underscore connect, so that is equals to ABC, and this is the, I define my ABC function here. So whenever I'll call my ABC function, first it will be print RC. RC means return code. Yeah, RC is the return code. If the return code is 0, it means that our client is successfully connected to the broker, and once it's connected, then after it will be subscribed to this topic. And whenever on underscore message callback function is useful to receive the message, and that is equals to ABC1. So whenever I'll be run the ABC1, so that is something print message.payload.decode means coming message. Yeah, we can be used a JavaScript, we can be used a Java, we can be used a C sharp, and we can be used a Python, any particular programming language, but JavaScripts, Java, C sharp, Python. We can be use that and implement this particular part. So generally I use the JavaScript and the Python for it. Okay, so let me just, I'll come back in this particular part. Let me just run this program. Okay, now you can see I'm receiving the 0. What is the 0? You can see the 0 is the RC code. 0 is the RC code, means written, this is the RC code. It means that our client is successfully connected. This is the 0. RC code means return code. It means that it's successfully connected to the broker. Then after it will be subscribed. And whenever any client will be published the message on ABCD1, will able to receive it here. So you can do one thing. you can open the same application. You can just open the same application. Okay. And you can see whenever you'll click on that small box, you'll get an option like subscribe to the topic, right? The right side of it, there's just some arrow, sign of the arrow. Just click over there. Click on that. Click on the sign of that kind of arrow sign. Please do that and give the confirmation. You can see whenever you'll get whenever you click on that particular small box that is appear after the some creating a client on your mobile applications. Okay, you'll get options like subscribe to the topic, and just right side of it you'll get some arrow sign. Please give me confirmation whether you'll be able to find or not. Please give me the confirmation through the chat box. Okay, so yeah, you can see. Then after, you can just define the topic name ABCD1 and the message that you want to send. You can see in your mobile applications, in your mobile application, you get options like from where you just subscribe to the topic. You get like you whenever you click on that particular small box, you will get options like subscribe to the topic, and just right side of it, there's just some small there's some arrow. Just click on that particular arrow. So now then you can be use that particular application as a publisher. So you can be mention the topic name as a ABCD1, and then you can be mention the message, and then you can click on the publish part. Okay, please do that and just give me the confirmation. Okay, let me give them an example of it. So you can do one particular things like just open that application, that small box. Remember from that particular point, you subscribe to the topic. Into the previous example, you subscribe to the topic, right? Just on the right side of it, the right side of it, you will get an arrow sign, upward direction, right sign. Just click on that. Click on that particular right sign. Please let me know all of you. Will able to find that particular part. Please give me the confirmation through the chat box. Give me the confirmation through the chat box whether you will be able to find or not. That point from you, you subscribe to the topic, just right side of it. Okay, okay. Just let me give me the time. I'll show you this particular part. Okay. Or either you can also download the MQTT box app. Okay. You can also download the MQTT box app. You can see, you can also find the MQTT box. You can download that MQTT box app to in your laptop, and you can just click on. You can just click on the create a client. And here you can see, I'm just using the protocol MQTT over the TCP. And you can just define your host broker address here. Okay. And you can just define the some name of it here. Click on the save. And once it's connected, you can see it's connected. Now we can just we want to publish the message. So it's ABCD1. And you give me messages like IoT training. And click on the publish part. And you can see, let me go back to the my program. And you can see we'll able to receive that particular IoT message, IoT training. You can see here. So in this way that we can implement it. Okay. So please let me know all of you if it's working for you. Okay. Oh, great. So same way, like you can also design some, you know, some kind of, you can use some Raspberry Pi and different kind of tools, and you can just interface different LEDs and bulbs, and then you can also like just define the GPIO pins, and you can design some solutions like to control the particular AC or the particular bulb through your mobile phone. You can design such kind of the applications over there. Means here you can just put a conditions if coming message like if the coming message like the payload, the decode equals to one. If the coming message is equals to the on, the light should be on. Okay. you can just do the programming in the Arduino and the Raspberry Pi, and you can also build such kind of cool applications, like you're able to control the AC or the bulb or such kind of the devices through your mobile phone. Okay. So in this way that we can be we can implement this particular part. Okay. So let me know, all of you, if you have any question till now, please. Okay, so I'm just going to close this part. Okay. So here now we'll see the particular concept of the cryptography, and so you can see right now we are not using any security features. Okay. Yeah, actually it's totally depend on the particular bandwidth and all. So obviously there will be some kind of the traffics will be occur in that particular part. So generally what we do in the real times, we generally don't use the such kind of the platforms like iot.eclipse.org or broker.hierarchy.com kind of platform. We generally use a very standard platform like AWS, Azure, and IBM's the Google IoT platform. So like whenever we build some kind of the software, we also do the load testings. Okay, the same thing, whenever we use the particular cloud platform, we also do the load testings, like how many we generally check it, the capability of that particular cloud platform, and based on that we can choose and we can be use it. Okay. So now we'll see this particular part. Now if you have any other questions, you can also let me know through the chat box, and otherwise we'll go with the one, we'll understand the security features using the cryptography, and yeah, that's all of the part. Let me know if you have any question. Okay, let's go with this particular part, and yes, please let me know if you have any question. Broker has sent key to receiver. No, actually in the cryptography techniques, what we do, we generally define some keys over there, and if the publisher and subscriber having the both key, then only they will able to use this kind of the, actually for the encryption purpose, there's a different way to for the data encryption. One is the symmetric encryptions or asymmetric encryptions. If the for the data encryptions, for decrypt the data or for encrypt the data, if you're using the same key, so it's known as a symmetric encryption. But if you're using a different key, like public key and private key kind of the concepts, where the public key can be used for encrypt the data and private key will use for we can be used for particular decrypt the data. So this kind of the mechanism known as asymmetric encryptions. Okay. So for there, the different kind of the security features, like here we are using the 183 port number, and we are not using any security features like data encryptions and all. But we can also use the SSL, we can also use the transport layer security, TLS SSL security, we can enable it, or at the times we'll use the 883 port number. But for that, we use the particular certificate based security, like public key, private key, digital certificates, and for data encryption smart, and also for network security, we use such kind of the features over there. Hash value, yeah, exactly. using the hash functions, using the digital certificates, we define the hash, some algorithms like RSA algorithms, we use it and we define the hash value, then after with the hash value with the public key, and then we compare to the particular hash values over there. Yeah, same thing, the hash functions, we use it, the digital signatures, that's kind of the concept, we use it in that concepts as a certain TLS. Okay, so this is something very broad topic, but let me give the one flavor about the particular, the security part. Okay, it's not possible to talk about the all about the SSL and TLS security into the one and two. So, but at least I'll give this some particular. Let's go with some particular part of it, the cryptography, and see that how we can be encrypt the data using the symmetric encryptions. We'll see. We'll use the same functions to the encrypt and to decrypt the data. Okay. Come again, let me check it. Can we use the computer and connection communications network? So I didn't get you, can you come again, Kilesh? Come again, I didn't get you, this particular one. Come again, Yeah, exactly. The encryptors generally change the particular normal text into some cipher text, so persons won't be able to understand the actual message. Okay, so we generally do using, there are two kind of the encryptions, like symmetric or asymmetric encryptions. So if you're using the same key for encrypt the data and also for to decrypt, let me just explain you through the graph and all. Okay. Okay, so here you can see, suppose that your message is hello. Okay, now we are using the some key, like some key is key, suppose that there's a key is AB12345602. This is the key that we have, and by using this key before send the data to the network, before to publish the data, we just encrypted this particular hello message, and now this hello message is something like in this particular way. So that's kind of part. Now the third persons won't be able to understand the actual message. It look like something kind of the garbage. Now the receiver part will be receive the same message. Now if the receiver having this key, right, so using this key, if it will be in decrypt the data, it can decrypt the particular garbage, that kind of the message, and convert into the original format. Okay, so here we are using the same key to encrypt and decrypt the data, so this is known as a symmetric encryption. Okay, but again, there's a asymmetric encryption, so there we use a two key. One is private and one is the public. Okay, the public key is generally available for the public, so the public can be used like for the encryption purpose, to encrypt the data. But we can only decrypt the data using the private key. Using the public key, we cannot decrypt the data. We can just only encrypt the data. We can only using this particular private key, we can just decrypt the particular data. The server generally have or the owner generally have the particular, the private key, and using the private key, it can decrypt the data and convert it into the original message. Okay. So this is something known as asymmetric encryptions. Or this key is something pre-shared, so both should be having the keys and all part. So we generally use this particular security features into the IoT world for data security, because in the IoT, the security is a very important part, right? Because we are working with a different hardware. So we talk about the security part, hardware security. Hardware security. Because you maybe heard about that, most of the time the persons or hacker also try to tamper the hardware. Because we are working with the sensor data, we are working with the microcontroller. If the persons will be trying to tamper the hardware or change the data value, then also it's a very big challenge. So we do the programming and we also put the loss of the security feature inside of the hardware. So before to use the access the hardware, or before to reprogram the hardware, the persons will be, there will be such kind of the authentications. The persons have to give them some kind of the password and need to enter the some kind of the password. So this is also we talk about into the IoT, the hardware security, the network security, data security, network security, database security, because we are storing some data some places also. Cloud security. For here, we generally use the X509 certificate. This is also the very famous, okay, for the security part. Because in the IoT, the security is a very big challenge or very important thing also. Because we are going to connect the millions of the devices to the network, so that we're able to communicate. Like suppose that if I implementing into the some banking or the finance sector, if you're implementing some manufacturing sector, then obviously I do not want to share this critical or informative information with some third person. So here the security become very big challenge. And to do so, resolve this particular part, we can use our different security layers on the hardware part, on the network part, on the particular data part, on the cloud platform, so that we can create a secure channel so that devices can be securely communicate and share the data. So that thing we generally consult into the security part. So this is the some, like you can say, some of the part of the IoT, the IoT development, where we use a different kind of you know, like a microcontroller, sensor, accelerator, cloud platforms, and we can be design the IoT enabled devices. After that, we'll also talk about the IoT security features. In the, we generally add the different security layers on the hardware, on the network, on the database, on the cloud, on the particular data, on the different particular pieces, so that we can design the secure environment for the devices. And after that, third and main part is IoT analytics, because we are collecting a huge amount of data that we can store it into the some database like DynamoDB, S3Bucket on the cloud base, or the some SQL, NoSQL database. We can be store it, MySQL database we can be created, and we can store the IoT data. But again, the, one of the big challenges, how to work on data and how to understand those data and how to find out some information from, extract the information from the data. So it can, we can use those information to take a good business decision. So this is something we use of big data analytics and artificial intelligence, AI techniques to work on data, or statistics. We use that to work on data and to extract the information from the data. Okay. So there's one question, what do you mean by SSL? So SSL means secure socket layer. Okay. So what happened, like we generally add the TLS SSL layer security. So you may be heard about like HTTP or HTTPS, right? Ashish. So HTTPS means it's the SSL secure. Means before to send the data, it's SSL provide the two kind of the security. First is data encryption. And second, because data encryption means it generally encrypt the data before to send the particular to the network. Okay. And second, security is generally also provide the authentication and authorizations, means no one, through that we can also check it. We can ensure that no one changed the data in the network. Like suppose that what happened, suppose that there's a one message, one device here and second device here, both are the communicating through the network and sending the message using the hello. But what happens, suppose that using the cryptography, you just encrypt the data, so third person won't be able to understand this message, but maybe the third persons can try to change the data. So the person, the receiver part will be received some wrong information. So SSL give the two COT in COT, like one is the data encryptions and second is authentication and authorization. Through that, we can ensure that no one has changed the data in the network part. There's one question, what do you mean by the encryption? The encryption means if your message is hello, so we are connecting into the some garbage message, so the third person won't be able to understand this particular garbage message, what is the, our actual message. Like if you are sending some important information. Like then in the particular network, you suppose that there's some hacker or some third persons are monitoring our messages. So maybe we can lose our privacy or some kind of the important information. So we do not want to do that. So we can use the data encryption. So before to send our data into the network, we can encrypt it. Encrypt it means we can be convert into the some garbage or random number. Like hello will be become the A11152221123. And by seeing the monitoring the A11233112 won't be able to understand what is the actual message. So this is the encryption part. Yeah, before to perform, then there's a one question, how the receiver will be know that what type of the encryption algorithms use. Actually, before to use this particular part, this and this key, and either if you are using the key or if you are using the certificate, is generally certificate is shared, pre-shared by both party. Okay, then only we can be use it. Before to implement this particular part, is generally the keys and the particular, if you're using the key or if you're using the certificate, is pre-shared between the both party, and then they can be use it. Or either like they can mutually define that they can become with your own algorithms, and they can be defined that okay, we are just good with these algorithms, will be use this algorithm for all the time for the different communication purpose. I didn't get you like call like. Yeah, now I think we can move on the particular code part. Okay. Yes. The receiver will be receive the garbage. Then receiver will be also use the same key to decrypt the data and convert into the original message. Because now receiver, suppose that the key is pre-shared between the both party. So before sender use that key to encrypt the data and data become the garbage, so receiver will be also receive the garbage, and using those key, the receiver can be convert that garbage into the original message. Okay, and if you're using the key or the certificate, yeah, for the decrypt part. Okay, so let me go back to the program and show you this example. Okay. Let me check it whether like this library is installed or not. Okay, it's not installed. So I'll go to the CMD. Make sure that part is specified. So pip space install. And we can just install this package using the command like pip space install space cryptography. Even into the path, and if you want to install the any package, you can just use the key like pip space install, then you can just enter the name of that package and you can easily install this particular part. Okay. Okay, perfect. So I'm just going to define one key first. Let me just do this particular part, then after I'll be explaining this particular code also. Okay, let me complete it. I'll come back to this particular program. Don't worry about that. Let me just complete it. Okay, so let me just run this program. You can see I'm publishing the two messages, two topic name ABCD1 and ABCD2. Okay, so let me just show you this part. Okay, there's a mistake here. Okay, so you can see this is the particular key that I'm using and C is not defined. And you can see if I subscribe on the ABCD1, so you can see I'm receiving the message like www.techtrunk.in/IoT certification. Now, the same thing, if I subscribe on ABCD2 topic name, the same message, but now it's into the encrypted format. So now you won't be able to understand the actual message. The third persons won't be able to actually understand the actual message. But if you have this key, like you can see, if you have this key, so then you can convert that garbage and convert into, you can use this particular key and convert that particular garbage into the actual message. Means you can decrypt that particular data and convert into the actual message. You can see using this particular key, first we are sending on the ABCD1, I'm sending the data. So what is the data? Data is normal data without any encryption. Okay, but now I'm using the cipher and the particular cryptography techniques and encrypted the data. You can see e-data is something encrypted data, and we are just publishing that same data but into the encrypted format. So we won't be able to understand this particular data. You can see the encrypted data look like in this particular way. So we won't be able to understand what the actual message. Okay, but using that key, we can decrypt the message and convert into the actual format. The actual message is this one. You can see here. Actual message is this one, but right now we are not using the any encryption technique, so we can receive the normal text and also able to understand the actual message. But in that case, we won't be able to do that, right? So using that key, we can convert into the that kind of encrypted data. We can decrypt the data and convert into the garbage, convert that kind of the garbage data into the some values, useful information part. So what about this code is like? You can see there's like some cryptography packages I'm using it, and that particular cryptographic package has a lot of the algorithms. Okay, using some algorithms, I'm just generating some key. Okay, and that key I just feed it into the some fernet, like same algorithms part. I just feed over there and assign the name as a C4. The C4 is some variable. I just feed the one key inside of some fernet. There's a lot of the algorithms which can generate the different kind of the keys, different kind of the encryption keys. Okay, so I just create the C4 and save that particular key and create one C4 means I just assign one particular algorithms and put the one particular key and using that we can encrypt the data. You can see if I run the program again and again, you can see there will be some different keys because it having the loss of algorithms and the loss of the keys. So whenever you run the program, it will be automatically, it will be used some different keys for the encryption purpose by default. So that's why we can first, we can be fix one key, and then after we can be use those key for the encryption purpose, then same key we can be used for to decrypt the particular data. Okay, but again, we are just, you can see here also we are using the 183 port number. We are not using 8883 because we are doing the encryption before to sending data. We are not doing the encryptions, or we are not using the SSL security into the network. We are doing before to send the data. So that's why this particular part. So for, we generally use the SSL or transport layer security through the some certificates, and this is the transport layer. All of the things took places into the transport layer. We don't do this all of the part into the programming. Okay, the SSL and TLS part. Okay, so same way, like there's a loss of the security features, and obviously like if you go into the detail, it will take more than 2-3 hours, more than 1-2-3, you can say more than 1 day to describe the, all of the SSL, TLS, hash value, hash functions, on the, all of the security aspect of the IoT. Okay, so this is a very broad topic actually. Okay, so let me know all of you if you have any questions for, at this moment, if you have any question, then please let me know. Okay, so right now you can just understand this particular part. We use those different security features like cryptography, digital certificates, and all for data security, for network security part. In order to secure our data or the communications, to create a secure communication channel, we use this particular part. Okay. And also, like there's a lot of the cloud platform like AWS, Azure, and whenever we connect this standard cloud platform, we can be used as kind of the SSL TLS security part, and we can create a secure communications with the cloud platforms and transfer the data over there. Okay. So that's all like for the today, like we'll now this enough for the today. So let me know all of you if you have any other questions. So now, because today is timing from 10 to 12 only. Okay. So let me know if you have any questions so that we can be discussed. And let me also talk about that. If you, in our particular training program, like we'll go with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, different sensor, actuator, MQTT, HTTP, CoAP, different protocols, AWS, Azure IoT, and then after augmented reality with the IoT, so you'll also get a flavor about the MQTT, augmented reality, and then how to interface with the augmented reality with the IoT part. Artificial intelligence with IoT analytics, some portions we'll also discuss. And you don't need to worry about that. You, generally, we start from the very scratch level. The, even the Python also from the very scratch. Like data types, variables, functions, loops, of all over the part from the very scratch. And then we go. So it's something of around the 40 to 50 online training, and that we generally go with the very scratch level and complete the all over the module like our Arduino, Raspberry Pi, and MQTT, HTTP, AWS, IoT, all over the security and also analytics with the augmented reality also. Okay, you can also connect us because we from every month we have a webinar. So maybe in the next times we can come with a particular Arduino topics. Okay, it's depend on the number of the requests on the particular webinar. So we generally organize that webinar based on the request for the, from the particular students. Okay. So there's one question like what for the runtime, the sensor data, like what we can do, we can just create a same infinity loops. We can store the sensor data into the some variable. And like here you can see, this is the something a variable like data. And same thing here, we can just, we can define to the, we can read the sensor's value and it will be stored into the data. And every time the sensor value will be changed and it will be published a different kind of the data over there. How can we know what type of the algorithms used for what? I didn't get you, like Sri, can you explain this particular part for what the algorithms for encryption? So mostly for network security, we use X509 certificate. We use a certificate-based security mostly into the IoT world. Public key, private key, digital certificate, X509 certificates, we use that. So there's any webinar on the augmented reality? Yeah, maybe in the future we can have a particular webinar on the augmented reality with the IoT part. Yeah, for the encryptions, like we use the mostly for the encryption parts, generally for the into the IoT part, we generally don't use the such kind of the symmetric or encryptions. We use a public key, private key, and that is we generally use the public key, private key kind of the concepts. And you can also, using the OpenSSL, you can generate a, you can random use any RSA algorithms, and you can randomly generate a different keys and using OpenSSL, and you can define that particular part over there. Yeah, that we can also do, Ashish, like using the OpenCB and Unity. No, we are not, broker is not going to store the any kind of the data, but what we can do, we can also install the MySQL and different kind of data. Broker is not storing the any kind of the data. Broker is just used for transfer that particular messages between the different clients. And we can also configure the, on the broker side, some, you know, if you're installing the broker in your laptop and also, we can also configure with the laptop, with the broker to the some database. So all of the data that we can store it into the, also some particular data like MySQL and SQL, NoSQL part, we can do that. There's one question is like, you can about the smartphone security systems using the IoT, please. Okay, like there's one question like, security system using. So again, let me tell you about that. The IoT is a very broad topic here. When we work on IoT and the IoT worlds, like for Android application software, for every particular point or every particular node, there's a different kind of the security features we generally need to consult. So whenever we work on a particular some Android applications, some into the smartphones or like some kind of the applications and all, like Android application for IoT parts. So their security is also the very important. Like we also use the different security features for authentication purpose. Yeah, we can send the image, audio, video, such kind of the data using the MQTT protocol, but again, it's the messaging protocol. Okay. AWS is a cloud platform. AWS is a platform, is provide the lots of web services. Let me just show you. You can see aws.amazon.com. So it generally provides the 1 year free task services so that we can reuse it. Okay, let me just go back. AWS is not only IoT platform, it's provided the loss of the web services that you can see this all of the services AWS provide, like compute, develop tools, blockchain, satellites, management, database, transfer, security, augmented reality, analytics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and different services. And one of the services are Internet of Things, you can see here. And there are different services like IoT Core, Free RTOS, RTOS, real-time operating systems, IoT OneClick, analytics, Device Defender, Device Management, Cement, Green Graph, Sitewise, Green Graph. So there are different IoT services. So we can connect to the IoT Core, like the same way like as we using to the SSL security by using some public key, private key, digital certificates, and 8883 port number. We can connect and work on this, collect the data on the IoT core and just store it into the some database, connect to the some notification service, then send the data for the analytics purpose. So different things that we can be do. Okay, so this is something part of it. Okay, like if you want, so again, like actually, like this is a part of cloud and also this is not into the, I'm not much familiar with the cloud services, so mostly into the, I'm working on the IoT and AI and augmented reality. So if you have any questions related to this one, so you can let me know. Okay. Okay, so if you have any questions, so please let me know, and you can also give the feedbacks on the you can go to the TechTrunk websites www.techtrunk.in, and you can give the feedback about this particular training over there also. And so augmented reality is something, let me tell you, means to add something on the real world, on the particular real world, means to add some virtual things on the real world. Maybe you watch some kind of the Hollywood movie, in that you can be see like the lots of the scientists, or into the science fiction movie, in the particular air there the loss of some small some virtual button, virtual dashboard appears, and persons, scientists or the particular persons try to click on that particular kind of the virtual buttons and all part. So means whenever you're trying to add something virtual things on the real world is known as augmented reality. AR with IoT is used for remote maintenance. You can search some videos on the YouTube later on, remote maintenance AR with IoT solution. You'll get a lot of details over there, lots of data information over there. Okay. Okay, and then thank you to all of you. Now I'm going to just end the today's sessions, and you can just submit your feedback over there. And in the future, if you are looking for some, if you're looking for to learn this particular technologies into the details, so you can also join our training, online training, the courses, and in that will be discussed detail into the with the AWS, Azure, IBM's, and the IoT Edge Analytics, IoT different things that will be discussed, the security analytics, augmented reality with the IoT, lots of things, Raspberry Pi, Arduino, into the detail course content. So you can also contact us and contact to our teams, and you can join to the training part also. Okay. For this particular session, then we'll, you can send us requests regarding to this particular part. Mostly we'll connect to you, we'll connect to all of you, and we'll send this particular PPTs and the videos also. Or you can also go with our YouTube channel, so you'll also get lots of information about the AWS IoT services and all part. And this self-paced videos, this IoT course is also available. And otherwise, you, if you want to join the particular live instructed lead training, so you can also join that. So you, for that, you can contact us. You can reach to the www.techtrunk.in, and then you'll get a complete information about that. Okay. Okay, then thank you to all of you. Have a good day. Now just I'm going to certificate. For the certificate part, you can just send the request. Mostly within the weeks, you'll get all of the certificate part. Into the 4 to 5 working days, you'll get a certificates. Okay. Okay, then thank you to all of you. Have a good day. Okay. And if you are looking for some complete course, so you can also reach to the our website www.techtrunk.in, and you'll get a complete information about that. If you are looking for some future particular webinar, so you can also send a request on the particular topic. Okay. You'll get an email regarding to the certificate and all of the parts. So don't worry about that. Okay. Okay, then thank you to all of you. Have a good day. Bye.